Do you see how it could appear or it could be perceived by anyone in the building or outside the building when they're Democrats? Could you see how it could be appear that it's politically motivated investigation?
No,
on their,
I could also,
on their behalf.
I could also see that multiple of those persons that we hired to work for us also worked in the U.S. Attorney's Office for a Republican appointee from a Republican president. So, no, I do not see that appearance.
I believe perception is truth to the person that perceives. So if someone perceives something, it's truth to them.
That second lawmaker speaking, it's all his strength from his mustache. We just played a video there. That was Texas Representative Tony Tenderholt asking the chairman of the General Investigating Committee about this impeachment of Texas's Attorney General Ken Paxton. Now, you might think, well, this is kind of a Texas issue. And yes, we have a lot of affiliates around the Republic of Texas, and we also have a lot of affiliates across the country. But I think that this issue is starting to grow into a national marker, I think is a good way to put it. Because Paxton is pretty popular across Texas. I mean, you would have to be when you start in 2015 and there's this like legal cloud that is around you and you keep winning re-election in spite of a lot of other, you know, the things that have been reported. And you are a fighter for a lot of, you know, conservative, a lot of the conservative agenda. And then you have something like this happens. And whether or not it was retaliatory because of what was done with Speaker Dade Phelan. And for those of you who don't know about Dade Phelan, I know y'all have seen the video of the guy who looks like he's drunk speaking on the floor of the House, because that was him. That went everywhere. There's a lot to unpack here. And I thought one of the best explainers on this came from Texas Representative Matt Schaefer, who had said, and I quote, "I publicly opposed Ken Paxton's reelection in the Republican primary, and I called out his very serious and moral, legal, and legal failings. But if it is right to impeach Ken Paxton, it is being done in the wrong way. Barring a drastic change in the nature of the House proceedings on impeachment, I will be voting no." He adds he doesn't have confidence in the procedure. He also adds that apparently members of the full House had no direct access to witnesses, supporting documents. They have not had any time to prepare or even understand the matters in question. And nobody even knows whether or not any of these people apparently like gave their testimony under oath. There's a lot of questions here. Texas Representative Matt Schaefer joins us via Skype now. Good to see you. Thank you so much for giving us some of your time today. So just to be clear, it sounds like you have never been given access to anything regarding this case or these cases, but yet you're supposed to make a determination based on like third party information.
That's correct, Dana. Not only were we not allowed to have access to the witnesses, we did not have access to the investigators. All we heard was an audio or read the transcript of the investigators talking to the five members of the committee. But during the impeachment proceedings on the House floor, I confirmed that none of the witnesses were ever put under oath. And the members of the House General Investigations Committee did not interview the witnesses as part of their process. And so to my knowledge, as part of the formal impeachment process, no member of the legislature was able to question witnesses. Now, there were some members who had individual knowledge of what happened with certain witnesses because of the relationships outside the chamber. Now, when you look at the procedure that was conducted in order to impeach Ken Paxton and essentially overturn an election, it was a sham. This was not the way it should have been done.
Wow. We're talking with Texas Representative Matt Schaefer on this impeachment of Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton. So it makes sense. Your objection to this is the sham way that it's being done, which is, it's weird because I just remember when we moved here in 2013. And I remember seeing all this stuff about Ken Paxton and all of these reports and, you know, the accusations about securities and all this stuff. And the girl, I mean, there was a lot of stuff out there. The guy kept winning re-election, you know, election after election. He was winning voters. He was out there in the ring fighting. He was pushing back on voter fraud, on mail-in ballots, you know, that don't have signatures and you can't match the dates. I mean, he's pushing back on all the right things. And it seems as though voters were aware of all of this because they saw the same stuff that I did. So aren't voters kind of the check and balance on this?
They should be. And if you were going to go through the constitutional process of impeachment to overturn that decision that those voters made, then you better have a really good process. If you're going to end up with an outcome that folks back home are wondering, what the heck happened? This really stinks. You better be able to go to them and say, hey, we heard the testimony. We talked to the investigators. We saw the evidence, and this was a just outcome. Dana, I can't do that. If I go stand in front of the people of East Texas and they ask me about this, I'm going to have to tell them that this process was a sham. And maybe there would have been a different outcome if we'd have gone through a really good procedure, but we don't know. And this was done in a hurried manner. The House General Investigations Committee operated for weeks outside the knowledge of rank and file members. And then when they did make their proceedings public, it happened so quickly. And they dropped this information on us. And this happened over the Memorial Day weekend. I mean, we literally had like 36 to 48 hours to process this information. We had little to no time to go back and look at the historical precedents of similar proceedings that had been done in Texas history. And many of the safeguards that you would hope would be in place for rule of law and due process simply were not conducted here. And I worry that trust has been seriously eroded. And we're living in a time where Americans are already skeptical of institutions. Mm-hmm. We don't need that kind of perception when it comes to how we conduct business at the highest levels of government in Texas.
And it seems, too, we're talking to Texas Representative Matt Schaefer, that if there's evidence here that Democrats or Republicans or the people who are pushing the suspension, the impeachment, and the investigation, they kind of undermined their cause because, you know, if they're demanding that you all make a determination based on evidence that has been withheld from you, then you usually only get one shot at this in the court of public opinion, and it seems like they blew it.
They did, and they told us, well, go read the transcript, go listen to the audio. Well, the audio was a conversation between five House members and investigators who had been hired by them. So we have hearsay there, but it's hearsay upon hearsay because the investigators were relaying conversations they had with witnesses, and the witnesses were relaying conversations they had with third people. So it was hearsay within hearsay within hearsay. And so we were not able to cross-examine anyone, and none of those witnesses were placed under oath.
Wow. Now, from what I've read, First Assistant Attorney General Brent Webster is leading the office, and the governor can appoint an interim or leave the position open. Any idea as to what's going to happen with that?
Governor Abbott does have the ability to put someone into that office to carry out the duties while Ken Paxton is suspended. I don't know what he's going to do. And Dana, it's going to be very interesting to see what the Senate does.
Because his wife is a state senator.
His wife is a state senator. But more importantly, folks back home are very concerned about the process that's being conducted here. And it just doesn't smell right. And, you know, I think sometimes there's this condescending attitude towards folks back home. Like, well, they just don't have all the information that we had. Or, you know, they just don't understand the rules of the House or how this was conducted. Let me tell you, folks get it. They smell that something was not done the right way. Now, I think folks back home know that Ken Paxton is not a Boy Scout. In fact, they know there's a lot going on there. And I've called out his moral and ethical failings. And I believe that he's dealt in some really dirty business. I believe that. But I had a constitutional obligation as a state representative to look at evidence and to not proceed without having evidence brought before the House, not evidence outsourced to people I've never met and never talked to. Hmm. That's not my constitutional duty.
No. Do you think, last question for you, do you think that because people keep saying that it's a witch hunt, which I think you kind of have to look at as to the nature of the accusations and the investigations and the charges that have been brought forward. But as for the process, it does seem, because it seems so shoddy, that it is really politically motivated. And it doesn't seem like it's just Democrats involved in it either. I know there's a lot of animosity between a lot of conservatives and, you know, the majority leader, the House Speaker there in Austin, Dade Phelan, and some others. Is that contributing to this as well?
It is. And the perception folks have back home, the optics, how it looks, it should have been done in a way that gave them confidence. Mm. And it just didn't. It eroded confidence. And if you're going to impeach a statewide officer and have the effect of overturning an election, then you better have an unimpeachable process.
There you go. Right there. I think those are wise words. Texas Representative Matt Schaefer, appreciate you. Thank you so much for your reasoned take on this. I think it's much needed. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Dana.